please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
What up, what up, what up, Jupiter? I'm Kirsten Fisher.
And I'm Madison Glone.
And as always, we have your JHS Student News for Tuesday, November 16th, 2021. Smithwick wins titles at State Swim Meet. Jupiter senior Heidi Smithwick was the lone swimmer from Palm Beach or Broward County to capture an individual event in either the Class 4A or 3A championships at the Sailfish Splash Water Park and Aquatic Center in Stewart. Jupiter's girls, led by Smithwick, were the top Palm Beach team, placing sixth with 132.5 points. It was the best finish for the girls in school history since 1990 when they were seventh. They also finished eighth in 2014. It was the result of countless hours of continuous hard work for years and dedication to swimming, said Jupiter coach Kirill Zakariev. Smithwick, a Princeton signee, won the 50-yard freestyle in 22.72, an automatic All-American time. I just wanted to make sure the team did as best we could because we didn't have any divers this year, said Smithwick, who was also second in the 100-yard butterfly in 53.85, another automatic All-American time. I was hoping to score as many points as I could, added Smithwick, who tallied 37 points for the Warriors and helped Jupiter finish sixth in the girls' standings with 132.5 points, the best finish for Palm Beach or Broward. It was my last high school meet of my career, so I wanted to make the most of it and make my team proud. It felt like my hard work paid off and everyone was supportive. It felt like the perfect race. Smithwick swam the second leg of the third place 200-yard medley relay along with Morgan Coggle, Isabella Kaupe, and Kiara Kamano that clocked a 145.38. Kamano, a senior, was runner-up in the 100 free with 50.76. Now, I don't know what these numbers mean because I am not educated in the swimming field, but I've been told by that announcement and also by how awesome our swim team is that this was an amazing win. So everyone in Smithwick's first period class, I want you to congratulate her right now. Round of applause. If I do not hear the round of applause, I will be very disappointed because she deserves it. And I'm giving you a round of applause too right now. That was amazing. Good job. You are phenomenal. You represent the best of Jupiter, especially in swimming. Keep it up, especially at Princeton. Congratulations. That's awesome. Good for you. Attention girls, play. Attention girls interested in playing flag football. Attention Caroline, who is interested in playing flag football. It is time to stop doing your homework right now and pay attention to the news.
I know you do homework. Hi.
Addison says hi, by the way. I don't. I'm telling you to pay attention. After Thanksgiving, we'll be having open field practices on the practice field every Wednesday after school from 3 to 4:30 p.m. Caroline, you must have your athletic eligibility packet approved and on file with the athletic director, the one, the only, Miss Kim Jong, before you can participate. You can turn in your eligibility packet to the one, the only, the man, the myth, the legend, Coach Embick in Portable 11. Let's go. Woo, Coach Embick or Coach G in Room 4217. Join the Google Classroom to keep informed. What is the code, you might ask? It is. Caroline, I want to see you writing this down right now. AX62ZU4. It's okay, guys. I've known Caroline for like 13 years. I can mess with her like this.
French Club meets this Thursday, November 18th at 2:45 in Madame Ellie's room 4104. Student Aces, we have a guest speaker coming on campus this Thursday, November 18th during fifth period and lunch. You must have a TLE signed to attend the event. The TLE can be found in Google Classroom or you can stop by Ms. Jom's office. You must also be an active member of Aces in order to have your TLE approved. The Ronald McDonald Club is hosting a Pull Tab Holiday Contest Drive in first period classes. You can get them from soda or any other cans. This club's mission is to create, find, and support programs that directly improve the health and well-being of children. You can drop off the pull tabs from your first period class in room 4116. They need to be washed, bagged, and labeled with the number of tabs inside. Please have your first period teacher's name and room number labeled on the submissions. The class that collects the most pull tabs will get baked goods. Start collecting now. Turn in your pull tabs by January 6, 2022. First Priority Club meets today during V-Lunch by the ceramics room in the courtyard. This meeting will be very special as we will have an inspirational message, pizza, and a game play. Everyone is welcomed to come.
Jupiter High School Black Student Union, all are welcome to our next meeting on Wednesday, November 17th, after school in Ms. Carlisle's room 5211. Please join us this Wednesday, November 17th, tomorrow at 8 p.m. as we send off the Spirit of Jupiter Marching Band to the state championship in Ocala. The event is open to the public at the Jupiter High School field. Get there early by 7:45. This will be a great time to show support to the Spirit of Jupiter Marching Band. The All Florida Chieftain Yearbook is on sale now for $85 at yearbookforever.com. You want to get this yearbook. It's going to be phenomenal. Absolutely phenomenal. Get it. Now. Do it. Scholarships, Bright Futures, and others. Palm Beach County Library System has partnered with Palm Beach State College and are hosting a free virtual event tomorrow at 6 p.m., 6:30 p.m. to address anything students are concerned with the panel. You must register at the link, which is in the captions, hopefully.
Thanksgiving food drives. Donate any non-perishable or canned food in rooms 4217, 6208, Portable 1, or in front of the main office for donation to the Palm Beach County Food Bank. Any chest has a 3-can/box minimum. Drop off items to room 1-155 during periods 1 through 6 and both lunches. Community service hours will be given for time spent collecting items if you leave a note with your name, grade, and student number attached to your donations. NHS is also collecting new unwrapped toys now through December 12th. The drop off box is in front of the school, or you can bring it to Mrs. Sparks, room 1-155. Little Smiles Clubs Holiday Toy Drive for Children in Need. Please donate toys to one of three boxes located in Mrs. Muncy's room 4110, Coach Mook's room 6215, and Mrs. Hansen's room 4206. Toys must have a value of at least $10. Visit the Little Smiles Holiday Toy Drive 2021 wish list on Amazon for ideas. If you have any questions, please see Mrs. Muncy or Magnolia Lang, the club's president. Thank you for giving back this holiday season.
The Beyond Breast Cancer Club meets today at 2:50 p.m. after school in room 5116. Come to learn about upcoming community service opportunities in our next event. Childhood Cancer Support Club meets today at 2:45 p.m. Members can come to Mrs. Rogers' room 7208 or log in from home. See you there. Attention juniors and seniors, applications for the Social Studies Honor Society are available and due by November 19th in Mrs. Hansen's room 6208. New members will be notified in January. Seniors that applied last year and were accepted do not need to reapply, but please check our Google Classroom page in December for important information.
Underclass yearbook picture retakes and makeups will take place today, November 16th, in the auditorium. Photographers will be on campus from 7:15 a.m. to 2:45 p.m. Students can get photographed anytime throughout the school day and will get a pass to return to class. Tennis. Any girl and boy interested in trying out for tennis this season, please plan on attending today's meeting right after school in room 4212. Paperwork and important information will be given out. Any questions, please reach out to Coach Babcock in room 4212 or Coach Lang in room 4107. And now the birthdays of the day. Happy birthday to Ashley Roundtree, Drake Andrews, Emily Barber, Ava Hoshella, Isabella Lamarigin, Nelly Lopez Vasquez, Mina Nelly Oklishin, Yemi Quisita Alvarez. Happy birthday.
And now stay tuned for the Class of 2025 candidate speeches. Voting will start tomorrow in your ninth grade English class, or you need to see the Class of 2025 Google Classroom. We have some very exciting people running. So have a great day, Warriors.
I, Phoenix Gulick, believe I would make a good fit for the Class of 2025's president position because I have many leadership like qualities such as maturity, honesty, respect, loyalty, and self-discipline. I am naturally very hardworking and would love to be someone who my fellow students can look up to, someone they can relate to and look to for guidance and support. I give everything 100% of my effort and will. Things will get done for the Class of 2025 if I am president. I am dependable and reliable and keep true to my word, always do what I say I will do. I thoroughly enjoy being involved as much as possible when it comes to school, and I hope you will take all that I've said into consideration for when it comes time to vote for the Class of 2025 president.
Oh. Hello, I'm Eric Lashinsky, and I'm running for your class president for the class of 2025. My priority is your wants and needs, and I'm going to strive to fulfill all your expectations for freshman year. It will be in my greatest interest to make sure you guys have fun this year. I have the motivation and attitude that I think represents a great leader. Those skills can be used to make sure that I am a good president this year that makes a difference. Something I want to propose for the 2025 class is a freshman class hangout outside of school. For example, a beach day, movie night, or bonfire. It would be a great opportunity for the freshmen to unite and do something. If we unite, we can fundraise for our class, and more money for our class means we can have more fun activities because more things would be funded. Thank you for your guys' time, and oh, I hope you guys make the right decision and vote me for your class president.
Hi, I'm Georgia Simon, and I want to be your freshman class president. So, I don't exactly have a lot of experience in school leadership, but I've always wanted to be involved, and what better time than to start now? But to vote for me, you have to know me a bit more. Well, I'm your typical Jupiter High freshman. I like the beach, hang out with my friends, and I like school, all except the tests. I like to think of myself as approachable, friendly, and a good listener that is open to all ideas. I'm interested in student government because I want to improve our school and our community. We don't all know each other yet because we have come from different schools, but I think our class has the opportunity to do some amazing things. Like many of you, I'm not from Florida. I moved here 4 years ago, and one of the great things about Florida is the beautiful weather. It's hard to believe that we all live in a place where we can have beach days 12 months out of the year. Since we are so lucky to have the beach right in our backyard, I feel we should give back to the place we all love so much. I suggest more beach cleanups that will make our beaches even more beautiful. We would also give out volunteer hours to anyone that helps out, as well as some easy fundraisers that will not only help the community, but allow our freshman class to do some super fun and cool activities. We could do things to benefit the sea turtles, the police department, or the elementary schoolers right across the street. One of the amazing things about this is we could all decide what to do together. I think we should make our next 4 years not just good, but incredible. I hope you choose to vote Georgia Simon for freshman class president. Thank you so much.
My name is Addison Glode, and I am running for the position of Social Media Manager for the class of 2025. I would be good in this position because I have experience being on the news crew and in SGA. On the JHS Student News, I can advertise our social media pages, as well as other important information that ninth graders need to know. And because I am in SGA, I have experience creating posters and flyers that can be used on social media or announced on our school's YouTube channel. I am also a developing photographer, taking a media studies class where we learn the basics of photography. On top of that, I know how to work Instagram as well as TikTok. All in all, I would be a great social media manager because I'm organized, responsible, good at public speaking, have experience, and can create cool looking and informational flyers. In conclusion, vote Addison Glode the GOAT for 2025 Social Media Manager.